All right, this is a demo on how to add an image to a web page. And this also runs you through the discussion of how to write a path. Because we have to have a path from the page to the image so that it will present in the browser window correctly. All right, we will be using the practice.html page we created in the last tutorial. All right, so right now I have an image out and I have saved it as a PSD. So I have it in theory, it has been edited and it has been cropped. It is resized. It is ready to go. So let's double check on image size. And it is at a width of 300, height of 400 pixels per inch. Okay, so you might be looking at inches. So I am going to change it to pixels. So now I know I have the correct pixels. Now this could be any size you want. It just must look good in your web page. It also has to be at resolution 72. All right, can't be 300, it has, or 150, it needs to be 72. All right, so I'm going to click OK, and my image is ready to export. Now, you need to already have a web folder set up, and my web folder is right here, my website. That's where we ended up last time. If I double click to open it, I will see inside it that I have practice.html. That is my file. It is at the root level of the root folder. My root folder is my website. Okay, I have added a folder for images. And I also have a folder for assets. So in my assets folder, I'm going to have the PSD file. Any PSD files can go in there. This is actually an assets folder, is a junk folder. You put anything that is not an active element on the web page goes in the assets folder. All right, then I have an images folder. In the images folder, you will have your images ready to place into your web page. And in this case, it would be a JPEG. All right, so, all right, I'll close that. I have my practice page open, practice.html. Hang on 1 second. Okay, I'm not changing the name of that. All right, so here is my page. I will click on, I have a browser window open just like last time. All right, so here's my practice page. I want it to present in the browser window. I like them side by side so I can work with them. So I'm going to click on the browser window, happens to be Chrome, and I will go File, Open File, and I'm going to click Find My Root Folder, click on my actual page, and open it. There we are, where we ended up last time. I want to place the image right here above this heading, which would have been which is the H1 tag. So I'll come over here and I'll click right after the body tag and put my cursor on the actual HTML page, and I'll click right between the body and the H1 tags. That's where I want to write the code for my image. So I'm going to type in an angle bracket, type the tag IMG, and there is an important attribute that you have to write in. It's called SRC, source. And source equals, in quote, And so this is the actual tag for a web page. And between the quotation marks, you're going to type in the path to your image. Now, let's figure this out. It's easy. So if I open up my folder and I actually look at the folder, and I come over here, just move it to the side. All right. So the image is inside the images folder. There it is. All right. Okay, the image is inside the images folder. The images folder is in my root folder, which is my website. So the first thing I need to do is we're going to write a relative path. It is relative to the page you are on. So it has a relationship between this page right here and the image in that folder. So we are on this page. So the path, the next thing you would have to do would be to go inside the images folder. So I'll write images and do a slash, forward slash. And now I need to write the name of the actual image file. ra-glas-img-prep1.jpg. An image tag is a singular tag. There are just a few tags that do not have an opening portion and a closing portion, or opening and closing, and that is the image tag. Also, the break tag is a singular tag. So all you have to do is put in this information to add an image. And here's your path. The path goes into the images folder, then it locates this file, and then it will present in the browser. Now, first thing you have to do after you make a change, save it. Okay, I just saved it. Click over here on the right-hand side, and I click refresh, and there's my image. The browser is reading all of this information from top to bottom. And now I have inserted an image.